Hey coding owls, welcome back to my channel. In this video we are going to talk about how to implement JSON with Java. Now what exactly I'm going to do here is there are basically lot of other APIs available for integrating or using JSON with your Java. In this video I'm going to talk about a specific library called as json/java. It basically comes up with the package org.json, and what we are going to do is we are going to download the jar file. Before that, let us have a quick understanding about what are the various packages available. If I want to rate top 3, I'll go for Jackson. Then I have got JSON, and nowadays JSON Java is the third one, and now Java library in JDK 8 have actually given support for its own library called as javax.json. We'll be certainly doing videos on that later on, but today we are going to focus on json/java. So let's jump into the content and try understand this. So the simplest way to use the JSON library with Java would be downloading the jar file from the given location in the description box. From there, you can just download the jar file and then set it in the class path. If you don't know how to set it in the class path, I have shared the link for the videos for setting the class path in the description box. You can quickly check it and then do the needful. Other thing would be to just go and download the dependencies for pom.xml file if you are using NetBeans or Eclipse. Again, on the same link where I have shared the link for jar file, I have kept the pom.xml file description, or you can just see from the screen right now and you can use the same. So once you are ready for implementation, it's very simple to understand. Let us understand what are the components of org.json package. Now what we are going to focus here would be the sum of four classes. The first is org.json.json object. So it is basically going to be a class which represents the JSON object. It is a combination of name and value pairs, where name is always going to be a string, whereas value can be any of the data type of the JSON what we have. We have discussed about it in the previous video. And yeah, a JSON object can basically have another JSON object inside it, or it can also have an array inside it apart from the basic key value pairs. Next, we will be talking about a JSON array. Obviously, a JSON array is something which is required when you are passing on the data on the internet. You'll require to send a type of similar type. So in that particular scenario, what you will do is you will pass a JSON array. Now JSON array is embedded inside a square bracket, and it can basically contain other key value pairs or objects. So there can be an array of JSON objects coming into your JSON. Then we have got something called as JSON exception. If something goes wrong in the JSON parsing or anything, there will be always a class which is going to handle it and which is going to throw some exceptions, which is nothing but JSON exceptions. And you have got org.json.xml. Now what you can say, XML was basically the predecessor to JSON in terms of data interchangeable language, or the format which was widely accepted. So there might be a chance that a previous application which is still working using XML want to communicate with a new component which is working with JSON. So in that particular scenario, it will be required that you go for XML. In that particular situation, the thing is very simple. There is a class with static method to convert your JSON object into XML and XML back to JSON. So we will be seeing the practicals about it in this series. You can go ahead and watch with the previous another videos. Now let's do a quick comparison between the Java JSON objects and the Java classes, as we are going to do the implementation in JSON. So what exactly happens here is we have got a JSON component. If it is JSON component is a string, it will be represented by java.lang.string. If your JSON component is represented by a number, it is represented by java.lang.number. If your JSON object is coming either as true or false, so we will be dealing with java.lang.boolean. A JSON object is actually made up of java.util.map, so the keys cannot be duplicated, values can. And a JSON array is actually made up of a list, so you can add as many as individual values or the JSON object directly inside it, and the ending one is the value of null, which is equivalent to Java null. So this was the package introduction to java/json library, which we are going to jump into practical in the next video. Thank you for watching this video. Do subscribe.